Welcome to Physics Made Easy channel. Today we are going to start electronic section and we are going to start with the first chapter, conductor, insulators and semiconductors. Any device whose action is controlled by flow of electron is called electronic device. There are two types of basic electronic devices, vacuum tubes and semiconductors, and we should add third type, integrated circuits. And vacuum tubes, before 1948, electronic devices were predominantly made of vacuum tube, for example diodes, triodes, tetrodes and pentodes. Now what is diode? In diode we have got, this is the cathode, this is indirectly heated, heat is supplied to the cathode, it emits electron and electrons are collected at anode. So this is diode valve. Diode valve means it works in one direction. If anode is positive with respect to cathode, then it works, and if it is negative with respect to cathode, then it does not work. As valve, it sends air in one direction and not in the opposite direction. Same is the case here. If plate is positive, I will write this on this side. Anode is positive and this is negative, then electron will flow. And if this is negative and this is positive, then there is no flow of electron. No flow of electron. This cross means there is no flow of electron. Now, triode valve. Triode valve which has three electrodes. So here a control grid was introduced. Now, in the previous case, there was only one element which controls the flow of electron, that was comparative voltages of anode and cathode. If anode is positive with respect to cathode, then current will flow. Now in this case, second controlling voltage is control grid, which is normally kept at negative potential with respect to the anode. Next is tetrode. Now in this case, this was a control grid. In tetrode, a fourth grid was, second grid was introduced and fourth element was introduced. It is a screening grid. So this was tetrode. And pentode, we have got control grid, screen grid and suppressor grid. So there were five electrodes. Now, in the beginning, in 1940s, about you can say 80 years ago, they were very much famous. And if you see the old Hindi movies, then you will see that very large sized box was used as a radio. And radio, most of the radio they used diode, triode and this pentode, etc. or vacuum tubes. The first computer made up with the help of vacuum tubes was as large as you can imagine a huge building in your city. A huge building in your city. It was so much large. Then there was another weakness. Once you supply the power and you switch on your electronic devices based on vacuum tubes, it will stay 1 or 2 minutes to start. And there were many other weaknesses as well. Now, we will proceed to classification of solids. There are three kinds of solids: conductor, insulators, and semiconductors. Resistivity, we are already familiar with the concept of resistivity. Let me remind you, in the chapter of electricity, we have done R is equal to rho L by A, where rho is resistivity and rho is R A divided by L. This is rho, resistivity, and its unit is ohm meter. for conductors, its value is 10 raised to power minus 2 to 10 raised to power minus 8. For semiconductor, it is 10 raised to power 5 to 10 raised to power 0. And for insulators, it is 10 raised to power 5. And on the same line, inverse of resistivity is conductivity. This sigma represents conductivity. This is represented by sigma and this is represented by rho. And now this is 10 raised to power 2 to 10 raised to power 8. Look, the difference between these two is this is power here is negative in case of resistivity and power here is positive in case of conductivity. And then resistivity for semiconductor is 10 raised to power 5 to 10 raised to power 0. And conductivity for semiconductor is 10 raised to power minus 5 to 10 raised to power 0. And resistivity for insulators is 10 raised to power 8. And conductivity is less than 10 raised to power minus 8. Examples, aluminium, copper, silver and gold, they are the conductors. And then semiconductors, silicon and germanium and their other organic compounds, even polymers, they can act as semiconductors. This is cadmium sulfide, gallium arsenide, cadmium selenium and indium phosphorus. And then insulators, rubber, plastic and putty. And so this we have studied their table. And now metal conductors, these are two solids which have high conductivity and low resistivity. Now what is the error normally committed by the students? For resistivity, they forget negative sign in the numerator. And for conductivity, they put negative sign. So this is the basic error which is normally committed by the students. And now semiconductors. These were those solids which have conductivity and resistivity in between metals and insulators. For example, I will take the case of conductivity from 10 raised to power 2 to 1. Is the transition phase, and now you can very well guess the fact that conductivity of semiconductor lies in between that of insulators, more than insulators and less than conductors. And same is the case of resistivity. Resistivity, the value of resistivity for semiconductors lies between the value of resistivity for insulators and conductors. You can very well see from this table. And now, naturally occurring semiconductors, they are silicon and germanium. Compound semiconductors, these are semiconductors which are made up of compound metals. We have already gone through this. And then organic semiconductors, anthracene, doped, phthalocyanines, and inorganic semiconductors, organic polymer semiconductors like polypyrrole, polyaniline, and polythiophene, etc. These are the organic polymers. And then we have got a band theory. So first of all, I will go through this band theory. We cannot afford to lose the sight of the band theory at present. Now, let me make this point very much clear that in atoms, we have got electronic levels. You have got orbits or energy level. I will call orbits. You have got orbits. Now, when we place two atoms closer, their outer shells, their outer orbits intermingle to form bands. And interior orbits, they remain as levels. For example, if we place now, I will take up this case. We are decreasing. I will first give you the broad concept and then details. These are the energy levels of two atoms when their interatomic spacing. Let me make a simple diagram. As I have to focus on this diagram, so I will move to this side. Yes, I will even put it better. Now, let us make a diagram representing two atoms. For example, I will show this one atom, and then we have got another atom. And here, this is the interatomic spacing. This is the interatomic spacing here, and it is represented by R. Now, at this level, say this is atom number, I will like to say X, and this is atom number Y. This is the distance between two atoms. And now I will draw one or two orbits to make an illustration. These are the orbits of an atom. And I will just show the two orbits for want of space. Now, if you are bringing them closer, for example, you are bringing them closer. You are bringing them closer. Now, there is no overlapping here. There are atomic orbits here. There are atomic orbits of this atom. And solids are made up of atoms. Atoms are placed on lattice points. And in some solids, atoms may be so much closer, their interatomic spaces may be so much less that there is overlapping. To illustrate the concept, now if I bring this towards this and this towards this, now what will happen? At one point of time, for example, there are orbits in this, there are orbits in this second orbit. And after that, there will be bands, not orbits. There will be bands like this. This is the valence band. Bands like this. When will they be formed? They be formed when two atoms, they are very much closer and they are overlapping. For example, now I am just representing two very closer points. These points may be farther one. For example, these are the closer points. Just like this. These are the closer points. And this is the overlapping area. Once overlapping starts, then electronic orbits start merging into bands. One band is called valence band, other band is called conduction band. Let us see how this happens. For example, this was the level when the levels are well separated. This case. And we are bringing them closer. We are bringing them closer. For example, this is, we are moving this towards this side and this towards this side. And their interatomic spacing is decreasing. For example, this. Their interatomic spacing is decreasing. So as a result, at this point, some kind of overlapping starts. Some kind, or the orbits starts thickening. And at this particular point, overlapping is complete. At this point, for example, these are the forbidden energy gaps. This is forbidden energy gaps. And now, as we bring them more and more closer, then here, the gap reduces. And at this point, gap becomes zero. If we still bring them closer and still bring them closer, then again splitting takes place. And at A, you can say at A, now what is the position of an atom? There is an outer band which is called conduction band, in which electrons are free. They are free to move. And there is, this is valence band. Valence band is the band in which electrons are still held by the nuclei. So this is the point. And now, this 3 points, again at D, no formation of conduction or valence band, there are only electronic orbitals. And we go on reducing the interatomic spacing at C, levels start coming closer, and approximately between, somewhere between C and B, if I draw a line here, overlapping is complete. And from this to this point, it is very difficult to distinguish to which atom electron belongs. And if atoms, they come still closer, then there is some kind of overlapping. And due to that kind of overlapping, valence band and conduction bands are formed. Now, if I represent energy levels of a typical atom, they will be like this. For example, first level, second level, third level. Let me draw it again, because there is enough space and we are not making use of that space. So this is here. For example, here we have got one level, second level, third level, and here we shall be having valence band like this. And above this valence band, there will be a conduction band like this. This is the conduction band. Now, so this is how bands are formed. So I have explained you informally. Now I will pick up some of the lines, because you may have to write in it in theory paper, or otherwise this article is not at all important from JE Main or NEET point of view, but it's very much important from theory point of view, and you could have gone through this topic even in chemistry. And now let me go through this topic once more. Here, energy bands. What are energy bands? You may be asked this question. A large number of discrete and closely spaced energy levels constitute energy bands. Now, when distance between them is larger than A, this is the case, distance between them, interatomic distance between them is larger than A. Now, at large interatomic distances, there is no interaction. So there will only be orbits. I have explained you this thing. And now when the distance is between C and D, there may be some interaction between C and D. For example, this is the point C. At this point, interaction starts. And here there is a very powerful interaction. But we are associated with only up to this point. Between C and D, when we are reaching nearer to C, interaction between the orbits starts. And 3s and 3p electrons, they are getting shared. And their level slightly changes. Now, this is the important phase that we want to discuss. When R is between A and B, तो इन दिस नाउ हियर बिटवीन ए एंड बी लेवल्स कंप्लीटली डिसअपियर एंड व्हेन इट इज लेस देन ए देन वेलेंस एंड कंडक्शन बैंड इज फॉर्म्ड एंड वी गेट ए स्ट्रक्चर लाइक दिस वेलेंस बैंड हाईएस्ट बैंड विद फिल्ड वेलेंस इलेक्ट्रॉन हाईएस्ट फिल्ड बैंड दिस इज हाईएस्ट फिल्ड एनर्जी बैंड It's not a level, it's a band. Band is made up of a large number of levels. You can think in these terms. Conduction band. It is the lowest unfilled allowed energy band next to valence band. And band gap is the gap between these conduction band and valence bands. And now from onwards, we will study next topic in the next lecture, and before finishing this lecture I will request all of you to kindly comment if you don't like, and if you like then kindly share. With these words, thank you very much.